So the future of healthcare is in the great hands, as how many millions of times have we said this, of the Cleveland Clinic?
We were just talking earlier. We said we're so lucky to have these great hospitals here in the city of Cleveland. The world-class leader in heart health really knows how to use manpower to give patients the care they deserve. But soon, artificial intelligence could be used for your health. And for more on AI in healthcare, we welcome Cleveland Clinic cardiologist, Dr. Ashish Sarraju. Good morning to you. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you here.
We've been hearing AI is good, AI is not great, you know, because jobs and things like that. But how does it actually, how can it help us with our healthcare?
That's a great question. I think our understanding of AI changed dramatically when ChatGPT was released.
Right.
That
you
know, is being hailed as sort of a revolution in AI that's not publicly accessible to everybody. You can, anyone can go to ChatGPT, ask a question, even a health-related question, and get an answer. But the million-dollar question is that answer correct?
Right.
And
well,
is it going to be safe?
Yeah.
Right.
I think that's where a lot of the attention is focused. The other place the attention is focused is models like ChatGPT can generate text and language. So can we use those in our usual healthcare workflows to write notes, send messages, make life easier for patients and doctors so that they can actually spend more time with each other as opposed to the computer on both ends?
And that makes sense. And I think that's such a big thing of a lot of the Cleveland Clinic doctors and doctors worldwide, that they want to spend more time with their patients, but yet there's so much paperwork to do too after appointments. I mean, you need to make those notes and do those things. You did a lot of research into this. Talk about that, your research.
Absolutely. So when ChatGPT first came out, we saw that a lot of people were posting a lot of things on social media, asking it questions and being surprised at how good the answers were.
Yeah.
Now, I'm a cardiologist. Specifically, I'm a preventive cardiologist. So a lot of patients come to us having done a lot of research on risk factors, prevention. So as soon as I saw that, we said, ooh, this is something I can see my patients using even now. So we got to try to figure out, is it going to be correct? So what we did with our group at the Cleveland Clinic is come up with a list of topics that we know our patients constantly ask on the internet or read books about, and see how well ChatGPT did in answering those questions as rated by cardiologists.
Okay.
In other words, would we feel comfortable
yeah.
giving the same answer to our patients? And we covered a wide variety of topics, 25 topics in cardiology. And we saw that 21 out of 25 times, it was reasonable. It was appropriate as felt by the cardiologists.
21 out of 25?
21 out of 25,
pretty
so about 84%.
Yeah.
Not a bad grade, but the caveat is getting four wrong is not great either, because in medicine, even one mistake can be really, really critical.
And misinformation,
yeah. So, but, so then you have a trust issue right there.
Yes.
People may not trust computers necessarily. They trust their doctors.
That's
they
right.
want to hear from a person as opposed to that. So while they're getting the information, can that be used in a good way?
That's right. You know, the question is, can that augment the patient-clinician relationship as opposed to completely replace it? I think you're right on the money there. That's where it should be used, I think, to try to help patients and doctors talk to each other in person like we're doing better. So, for example, if maybe if a patient wants to schedule an appointment, or a doctor wants to make a letter to send to the patient's insurance company appealing a medication, maybe that doesn't need to take up half the doctor's day.
Yeah.
Maybe that is something ChatGPT or similar AI models could do, so doctors can actually focus on patient care.
Which would lessen the anxiety
to
patients,
too. Yeah, it really would. What's the take-home for patients, for people who are at home watching right now, kind of wondering where they fall into this whole mix?
Absolutely. So I think we're going to see major research and changes in how AI is going to be used in the healthcare field. And we may even see AI being deployed on the front lines for things like this, for appointments and things like that. What I would tell patients is ChatGPT and these models, they're not ready for answering healthcare questions yet. So whatever you do, don't enter your private health information into it, and don't rely on it 100% to answer questions.
And they won't be replacing your surgeon anytime soon.
I don't believe so.
That's the big thing people are worried about, I'm sure.
I know.
Doctor, thanks so much.
Thank you very
great
much.
Great to meet you. Good information.
Yes, it's great to have you on board.
Thank you very much.